let's come back. I was saying as soon as blood pressure goes down, carotid sinus through the sinus nerves, right? This is through the vagus, ninth nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve, right? This is message is given to the central nervous system that blood pressure is going down. As soon as central nervous system senses that blood pressure is going down, it will stimulate the sympathetic outflow through vasomotor center in the medulla. So from the medulla, fibers will come down, neuronal connections will come down and stimulate what thing out? Stimulate sympathetic outflow. This sympathetic outflow, which is going out, suppose these are preganglionic sympathetic neurons and here are postganglionic sympathetic neurons. I will not go to detail of all sympathetic fibers. Right now, we are concerned only with those sympathetic fibers which are coming to juxtaglomerular apparatus. These are sympathetic neurons which are coming to juxtaglomerular apparatus. Actually, as soon as blood pressure starts going down, vasomotor center is stimulated, lot of sympathetic outflow come. Some of the sympathetic fiber come to juxtaglomerular apparatus. And what they will release there? They will release, neurons will release norepinephrine. Right? And these cells have receptor for norepinephrine. These are beta 1 adrenergic receptor. What are these receptors? Beta 1 adrenergic receptor. You must know there are beta 1 adrenergic receptor present on juxtaglomerular apparatus because beta blocker block them also and help us in hypertension management. So the beta 1 adrenergic receptors present over here. So sympathetic outflow stimulate these beta 1 receptors, and when beta 1 receptors are stimulated here, more release of renin, according to Mr. Hadayat speculations, more release of renin. So how many mechanisms are there to release the renin from here? Number one, two local and one systemic. Intrarenal mechanism is low blood pressure in the afferent arteriole and low sodium concentration to the macula densa. Both of them release renin. These two are intrarenal mechanism of release of renin. Extrarenal mechanism of release of renin is most important, sympathetic fibers connected with that. Is that right? So we see this juxtaglomerular apparatus can measure the pressure directly, can measure the sodium concentration directly, and in every emergency, whenever sympathetic nervous system will fire, renin will come. Now what this renin will do? Let's see what this renin is going to do. This renin is going to the general circulation. From the renin will go to the general circulation. Now renin has come to the systemic circulation, right? Through the renal vein. Now what renin will do here? I told you renin is an enzyme, right? And every enzyme work on special type of substrate. It will also work on some special type of substrate. Before we go for that, you know, liver has a lot of hepatocytes. Hepatocytes produce a lot of protein normally. You know, they produce albumins and globulins, alpha globulin, beta globulins, but not gamma globulins, because gamma globulins are immunoglobulins, antibodies which come from plasma cells, B cells. But most of the proteins, other than the gamma globulins, most, not all, but most of the proteins are produced by liver cells. Liver cell produce one very special type of protein normally, and this protein is called angiotensinogen. Angiotensinogen, right? Angiotensinogen, okay, I will write it in small way. This is angiotensinogen, right? From where it is coming? It is coming from liver, and it is not coming only during crisis. It is produced by the liver all the time. Right now, all of you have in your blood angiotensinogen. But as soon as renin come, it will work on angiotensinogen. It will work on angiotensinogen and convert the angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. It is angiotensin 1. So what is the function of renin? Renin is an enzyme which can convert angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. Is that right? Now, all of you know it, that when angiotensin 1 passes through the lungs, it converts into angiotensin 2. That is the crux of understanding, na? That angiotensin 1, when it is passing through the lungs, it converts into angiotensin 2. It means in the lungs, there should be some enzyme which convert angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. And that enzyme is called angiotensin converting enzyme. Again, when angiotensin 1 passes through the lungs, it converts into angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2. Right? When angiotensin passes through the lungs, it converts into angiotensin 2. This is large protein molecule. It is decapeptide, 10 amino acid. Then there is an enzyme in the lung which break down 2 more amino acid, and this product is octapeptide, only 8 amino acids. I want to know one thing. Angiotensin converting enzyme, on which so many drugs work, angiotensin converting enzyme are present in which part of the lung? Are they present in bronchioles? Are they present in alveoli? Are they present in capillaries? Are they present where? Where in the lung angiotensin converting enzyme is present? All of you know there are many drugs which inhibit that enzyme. We must know where is that enzyme. Yes, we talked to Abbas. No idea. Jamie. Same. Yes, Hidayatullah. You are with the majority, or you will try to guess something? In the lungs, everyone has heard there is an enzyme called angiotensin converting enzyme. Have you heard of it or not? MashaAllah, you have heard of it. Where exactly it is present? No idea. No idea. Jamie, just guess it. Wild guess. You don't want to even guess. Maybe it is present on the pleura. Yes, any wild guess. Alveoli. What do you think?
Yeah, pneumocytes.
Pneumocytes. Okay, write it down on the book and put a very big cross on this. You know why? If it is present in alveoli, then tell me one thing, it means your blood has to pass through alveoli. Alveoli are blood flow system or air flow system? The air pockets or blood pocket? Yes?
Capillaries and alveoli?
No, the alveoli are air pockets and pulmonary capillaries are attached with them. But pulmonary capillaries are not alveoli themselves, right? So, one thing is sure, alveoli should not have the enzyme, otherwise there will be tragedy. Blood has to jump into alveoli so that angiotensin 1 should convert into angiotensin 2. Okay, let me explain. Actually, here is alveoli. Let's suppose this is airway. And these are suppose alveolar system. These are air pockets. Of course, blood should not enter there. Is that right? Actually,